It's been a good year for Emira Property Fund, but the year ahead is set to get tougher, particularly in the office property space. The fund has grown its full-year distribution by 8.8%, but it's already warned investors that they shouldn't expect any distribution growth for 2017. Earlier, Stephen asked Emira's CEO, Jeff Jennett, about the sudden turnaround from the 2016 earnings and the 2017 forecasts.
Just to contextualize it, FY16, 146.1 cents dividend per share, and we're anticipating, based on the information we have at the moment, 143 cents dividend per share for FY17. We are seeing difficulties in our office portfolio. We've got 144 buildings, and eight of those buildings are where the difficulty is, and all eight of those are office buildings. Five of them are in Pretoria, and so that's where we're seeing some.
And there's 30,000 square meters of space that suddenly became vacant. How did it become vacant so suddenly?
So tenants gave us notice at the end of February, in March and April and so on, letting us know that they are no longer wanting to take the space. And that's always the difficulty, is that you've got leases that are coming up for expiry, you anticipate to renew them, you do your work with them, and then sometimes, unfortunately, and in this particular instance, we've had eight buildings all happening at the same time that we anticipate now through FY17 becoming vacant. And that 30,000 number, that's exactly it. The drop in our distributions is the 30,000 square metres on average for FY17 multiplied by a through rate of 150 rand a square metre gives you 4.5 billion rand a month, times 12 gives you 54 million rand, and that's 10.5 cents in terms of our distributions that we are no longer going to be having for FY17.
And how difficult to fill those offices in a tough economy like this, Jeff?
It's certainly more difficult. You are seeing an oversupply of office space, and certainly in some nodes. You are seeing pressure on rentals where tenants are battling from their side, just from an economy perspective. Mm-hmm. And so we are competing for the same pool. And so it certainly has become more difficult. We are having to throw more money at it in terms of tenant incentives, in terms of the refurbishments to the buildings, and we're having to accept lower rental reversions in order to get tenants.
Are you also trying to reduce your exposure to the office space, and particularly the lower grade office space in this environment? Yes.
So in the last four years almost, we've been progressively reducing our exposure to the B grade office space and moving up the curve in terms of the A and the P grade. We've got some fantastic office assets. And from our side, that's certainly a strategy we want to continue moving up the curve, but we also do feel that our mix at the moment is 44% offices, 41% retail, and 15% industrial. Retail and industrial are certainly more defensive in this sort of economy than offices. So it is certainly our plans to reduce the 44% number to a more manageable level going forward, and increasing our exposure through to retail and industrial. That might mean that we do reduce and sell off some of the assets, or alternatively we grow in the retail and the industrial side, and certainly a smattering on the residential side too.
And you do talk in the commentary today about the effects of recycling of capital, where you are selling non-core assets and plying that money back into acquisitions, but also upgrading your existing properties.
Yes, absolutely. I think one of the most exciting ones on the retail front is our Cromerville Corner development.
Which everybody in Joburg would know, so they're in Desmond Street, yeah.
Absolutely, and it's an amazing what we've done there. We've taken B-grade office space, lower grade showroom space, and turned it into a designer showroom node. It should be worth around about 220 million rand when we finish now in September. We've signed up some long-term leases at some good rentals, and it's definitely very exciting. There are two other places that we are developing. One is our Knightsbridge redevelopment in Bryanston, where we're taking 10,000 square metres of B-grade office space, converting that to 30,000 square metres of prime 4 Green Star P-grade space. That happens in phases. Our phase one is underway with a 7-year lease with an international tenant, and we're getting pretty close to actually signing up another international tenant on a 10-year basis that would kickstart phase two. So that's a very exciting one. And then the third one that we're very excited about is our Summit Place development, which is in Menlyn, Pretoria. And there we've bought 50% of 5 buildings in that office and retail complex, and that's right at the gateway into Menlyn. So we're certainly very excited about that. That will come on stream in the rest of calendar 2017.
Mm. And Jeff, you were in a couple of weeks ago, we were chatting about Arrowhead's unsolicited offer for the company, and you were talking about the quality of your portfolio versus the quality of the Arrowhead portfolio. And do you think this justifies your stance, the fact that you are improving the quality of your overall portfolio?
Definitely. When the market gets tougher, you've got to be in the quality assets. The quality assets will survive without doubt. So our strategy that we've been embarking for the last 3 years to move up the quality curve has definitely been the right the right decision. And if I go back on the Arrowhead side, their non-binding expression of interest, they certainly play in the lower end. And it's not something that we would want to go to. And certainly in a tougher market like this is not something that we're wanting to do. As I mentioned earlier, we're looking to reduce our office exposure even further than what it is.
Any developments since we last spoke, Jeff? Has Arrowhead come forward and chatted to your board? Because that's something that hadn't happened at that stage.
There have been no developments at all. We rejected it unanimously about 3 weeks ago, and we've heard nothing. We are in our results, year-end results stage, and I'm sure investors are looking forward to seeing our results, and they can be impressed with a quality FY16 results. And I'm sure coming out of that, shareholders will be able to look at it and understand why we rejected the Arrowhead expression of interest.
Property Group CEO Jeff Jennett. After the break, it's Smart Money, so don't go away.